Hey you guys, welcome back to Premiere Gal. In this video, we're gonna have some fun and do some do-it-yourself DIY camera movement transitions. You can use any camera that you want. I'm using my Canon M3 mirrorless camera that has the flip-up selfie style with my Joby GorillaPod rig, so we can move the camera, have some fun, and do some do-it-yourself camera movements. So let me show you how to do it. Let's get started. And here we are in the Golden Gate Bridge, and all I had to do was think ahead creatively. I moved the camera into my eyeglass and popped it out in a new location. And so the same thing can be applied to any other type of camera movement. So let's do a transition into the sky, and I'll just drop my Joby tripod down. Ready? 1, 2, 3, bam. All right, it's super windy out here at the Golden Gate, but let's do a pretty cool spinny transition. Ready? All right. And now we're in Fisherman's Wharf, San Francisco, and let's clap. And now we're at Lombard Street, the most curliest street in the whole world here in San Francisco. Pretty awesome. Whoa, woo, that was a close one. Here we are at Alamo Square. See the painted ladies back there? Pretty cool. And here we are, typical San Francisco apartment building here. And let's try this transition. Whoa. And now here we are in a beautiful park in San Francisco. It's known for its greenery. Look at that tree back there. Isn't that awesome? And now let's try this transition. And here we are, downtown San Francisco, Mission Street. Take a look. Looks pretty cool, huh? And now let's try this transition here. Let's throw this. All right. And I'm here with Jason Levine.
Hi, Kels.
Hey, we just had dinner in San Francisco. Awesome. Anyway, I'll see you guys later. So here we are back in my desk space. I had a wonderful day in San Francisco shooting all these cool transitions. So let me walk you through exactly what you need to do to reproduce every transition I have here. And then we'll jump into Premiere Pro and show you how to edit them together so they work. This video was made possible by support from Production Crate. I use their textures and overlays to add sweet glitches, leaks, and lens flares to my videos. I also really love using their MoGraph elements and transition effects in my videos. They're really easy to use. Just simply drag and drop them into your timeline and they're done. And to top it off, they also have a library of music and sound effects, so you really can make it awesome with Production Crate. Some elements are free, but if you want unlimited downloads, it's just $49 per year. I've linked to my favorite Production Crate effects below. Thanks, and now back on to the tutorial. First up is the sunglass transition. In your first location, just quickly pull in your camera lens into your sunglass lens. Then, while in the second location, start the camera lens in your sunglass and just pull it back out. Then in Premiere Pro, drag and drop the first location shot into the timeline and cut where the sunglass is fully in the shot. Then drop in your second shot and roll back the start of the first shot here until it matches the same composition as the first shot, so when it's fully in frame. And then you have your sunglass transition. Next up is the sky transition. While you're vlogging in your first scene, just simply drop your camera straight ahead of you so the lens points up towards the sky. Then in your second location, start in the same position and then pull it back up vlogging style towards your face. In Premiere Pro, this edit is simple. Simply cut the end of the first clip to the point where you just see the sky in the frame, and then for the second clip, cut it at the start where the sky is also fully in frame. So there you have it, your sky transition. Next is the 180 degree spin transition. Start in your first location with your camera held in selfie vlogging style, and up to you, you can spin to the left or to the right 180 degrees. Then in the next location you go to, make sure to spin again. Just make sure to spin in the exact same direction as before. Then in Premiere Pro, end the first clip transition halfway, 90 degrees into the spin, cut there. Then in the second clip, cut halfway into the spin, and then splice the two clips together so it looks like the second location finishes the first location spin. And there you have it, the 180-degree spin transition. Next is the clap transition. Just set the tripod down, it's easier on a bench or a stand, and back up a couple feet, and then clap your hands in frame. Then in your next location, try and remember where you were standing. I'd recommend playing back the footage just to be sure on your camera. Stand in the exact same place and clap again, but in a new location. Then in Premiere Pro, for the first shot, cut it when you first clap your hands together, so right at the moment when your hands touch. Then for the second clip, just cut the clip when your hands are about to release again, so it's a match on action. And now play it back, and there is your clap transition. And fifth is the collapse into self transition. In the first location, I grabbed my GorillaPod and I pretended like I knocked it into myself. Then in the second location, I brought the camera into my chest and popped it back out. Now in Premiere Pro, you're gonna cut the first clip once the camera falls into my chest. So at the end of this clip, you want it to be complete darkness. Then in the second location, you're gonna cut it while it's in my chest and then about to pop back out again. And then you splice them together, and then there is the collapse into self transition. Now for the standing jump transition. Here you're just going to stand and hold your GorillaPod and lens pointing at your feet parallel to the ground and jump as high as you can while keeping the camera as parallel to the ground as possible. Then move to your next location and jump the exact same way and try to hold your camera at the same level as you were before. Then in Premiere Pro, at the end of the first clip, when I'm jumping, cut it at the moment where I'm jumping in the air. Then for the second clip, you're gonna start it while I'm in the air, cut there, splice the two clips together so it looks like I jumped up and I'm landing, but this time in a different location. So that's how you create your jump transition. Next is the ground fall transition. As you set your GorillaPod on the ground, just simply push it over to the side so the lens points down into the ground. Then in your second location, start off the motion by laying the camera down in the grass, just like it was in the first shot, so it's pointing down. Then in Premiere Pro, just like the other shots, cut the end of the first shot while it's in the grass, and then cut the beginning of the second shot to start in the grass, just before you pull it up off the ground. And now we have our grassy ground fall transition. And eighth is the zoom into face transition. I could have done a better job here. I was kind of silly, and because I closed my eyes, it was hard to tell if I was fully covering the shot with my face. So just fully extend your arm out in your first location, and then quickly pull the camera towards your face. Then in the second location, start with the lens fully in your face. And while your eyes are closed, then pull your hand out and then open your eyes again. Then in Premiere Pro, cut the first shot at the end where the camera is as close as it is to your face. And then cut the start of the second clip while it's fully zoomed in. And there you go, there's the face zoom transition. And number nine, one of my favorite transitions, it's throw an object transition. Here in your first location, throw any object up in front of your camera as you hold it. Then in your second shot, just mimic the exact same throw in a different scene. Then in Premiere Pro, you're going to cut the first clip at the end while the sunglasses, in my case, or whatever object you have, are above the camera so you don't see them and just your hand in the frame. And then cut the second clip where the sunglasses fall back into your hand but in the different scene. And there you have it, you have your throwing object transition. And lastly, but certainly not least, the camera flip transition. In this scene, while vlogging or filming the selfie style, you want to flip your camera directly upside down, as I do here in this scene. Now, I forgot to film the second half of the scene showing what I did back at my desk, but what I did was the exact same movement, but I started with the camera facing down and then I flipped it back up again. So in Premiere Pro, just cut the first clip here when the camera is fully rotated upside down. And then with the second shot here, you want to cut it when the camera is upside down and about to rotate back up again. And splice them together, and voila, you have your flip transition. So that's it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it and that you start doing your own DIY do-it-yourself camera handheld transitions. And if you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. YouTube likes it when you like my video and it helps my videos do better. So thank you in advance. Also be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you're notified when I make new videos every week. And lastly, if you're feeling generous, you can leave a tip in my hat here by going to patreon.com/premieregal to leave me a tip. And as rewards, I design After Effects and Premiere Pro templates that you can get, and they're pretty cool. Thanks again, you guys, and I'll see you all very soon.